you know, what they've done in this world, they matter. And they matter to me. You know, like, I don't have to know your story for you to matter. You know, like, I love you just the same. Think I can fly. Think I can fly. All right, welcome back. I am so happy to be back. You guys don't even know, like, I'm just so happy to have free time and just to be able to do a video for you guys. I'm just even happy to have on foundation today because Lord knows his eyebrows, like, let me show y'all my eyebrows, like, okay, these eyebrows, okay, nursing school is like taking my life, okay, they're like, what is eyebrows, okay. So, why that camera get focused, but okay, cool. But I am so happy to be back. I have some life updates, some nursing school updates, some events, some things that, you know, just have been happening this last month, and I'm so happy to be able to share with you guys. So if you guys want to know what I've been up to this month in my first semester of nursing school, you know, and the challenges and everything that I had to go through, then just stay tuned and I'll be with you. So cool. All right, you guys, so let me tell you, like, dude, it has literally been a challenge for me. I have finally completed my first class of nursing. Yes, honey. Yes, I'm done with that first class, and I did successfully pass that. That was my farm class, and I'm so happy that I'm done with that because it literally, just having that class and another class, it literally was stressing me out, the amount of workload that I had to do, because if I was not studying for one class, then I was studying for the other. I've had a test almost every week since the start of January. I've had a test every week. I've had two practicums in that class, and one of them I failed, and I panicked. I didn't really panic, but if you guys want to know, like, how I failed my practicum and what I did and how I overcame it and just stuff like that, then just go ahead and let me know in the comment section below, you know, or what type of practicums do you have in nursing school, then just let me know below. But I did want to talk about, you know, just, I completed my first class, and now as far as, like, what we're going through now, we are in clinicals at a actual facility, and we're, you're doing long-term care, this facility, at this course of our stage of our nursing school. And so I just started with my long-term care after passing my practicum and passing my math practicum. We are in a long-term care facility. What I will say is I got really sick about the, I'd say about a month and a half in, I got sick. And I got sick because I was really stressed out in nursing school. I was having to test every week, quiz every week, practicums. And I was just doing a lot of running. You guys know I, like, work and I go to school and I have a kid. So I was just doing a lot and not really taking care of myself and not really taking care of, like, my gut health and things like that. So I got really sick, and it kind of put me down for a couple of days. So I just realized that I have to take care of myself. So you guys remember that no matter what you do in this life, that you want to make sure that you take care of yourself. You know, don't let stress and things that you're going on to let you neglect yourself first, you know. So I did eventually end up, you know, getting better, start putting healthier things into my body. And because one of the things that go out on me first is my brain, you know, like my brain. And if I can't think, I definitely can't do what I need to do at my job, nor can I do what I need to do at school, which can eventually affect somebody's life. So remember to take care of yourself while you're going through nursing school. Another thing, like I said, I completed my first class. I did get a B in the class. I would have loved an A out of the class, but unfortunately, with the amount of work that we had to do and the grading at our school, a 93 and above is an A. Okay, So anything like a 92 and below is a B. So, you know, so you definitely got to be up there. You got to make a lot of A's on your tests, and one B or one C could definitely drop you down from that A. So that's definitely it. But I made a B. I'm happy to make my B. I'm happy to be done with my first nursing school course and to have completed that. That is an accomplishment for me. I went to clinicals on my first day, and one of the things that I had to deal with, which was really hard for me, was a patient had passed away on my first day of clinical. And this was not something that I was prepared for. It was not something that I walked in and I was like, okay, this is something that I could possibly deal with today, you know. And if anyone knows me, they know that I'm a crier. Like, I might not come off as a crier, which is what's so funny about, like, all my friends. Like, the people who truly know me know that, like, I'm really heartfelt and I really care for other people and I have empathy and I love people, whether that I know them or I don't know them. I just love people and I love their stories. I literally will look at Facebook or look at Instagram or read an article and I will cry if I see something in there that really touches me. So I'm a crier. I didn't think that I would have to deal with it so early on in my nursing career. I did know it was something that I would have to deal with. So, and I'm not gonna say that I was prepared for it. I just knew it was a part of the process of being a nurse. This is my story, you know. We're first day of clinicals, and you know, there was a gentleman at our facility. You know, he came. He said, "Hey, you know, this is a good learning experience for you guys, and I would like for you guys to come and learn how to be able to take care of an individual." Because as a nurse, you have to learn, not only do you have patients that die, and it is your term of care don't stop at that point. You know, like, you have to prepare your patient for the next step. You know, so you don't just have a patient that passed away and then you're just like, okay, well, we're just gonna send them off to wherever and they do whatever. You know, there are things that happen to a patient's body, like, as they pass away. So this was a good learning experience for us as nursing students to be able to learn how to how to be able to take care of a patient's body once that patient passed away. So we were asked to come in and, you know, and get this learning experience from the patient. And you know, fortunately for me, I don't do well. Like I said, I'm a crier. So I like kind of try to hype myself up really fast, like quick and in a hurry, like try to hype myself up. And I was like, okay, I got this. I'm gonna go in here. I got this. Melissa, you got this. So I go into the patient's room and I first try, you know, just to be kind of calm, you know, look at my other students and kind of just look around the room without, you know, naturally looking at the patient, you know. And because I just knew, like, once I looked at the patient, I knew that I would feel some type of way. And fortunately, I was forced and I looked at the patient. When I looked at the patient, I kind of like looked up to the sky and I'm like, okay, I got this. And I looked over at my teacher and I guess she could tell there was something wrong in my face because she said, "Are you okay?" She mouthed that to me and my brain just burst and was like, "Abandon ship. No, Melissa, you don't have this. You do not have this." And I did not want to literally start hysterically crying right there in the patient's room. So I had to literally step out of the room. And I started to hysterically cry. I started to hyperventilate as if that patient was my patient, was my family. And, you know, and I like started crying and I hysterically kept crying. And even I could not get myself together. I had to like go sit down. And although like I could functionally speak and I kept apologizing to everybody, like, "I'm so sorry, I'm so sorry," my body just kept crying. And the reason I cried was not necessarily for the patient, but I knew that patient had people who loved them. And I knew somebody else was going to be sad today. And although I didn't know that patient's story and I didn't know what was going on or what happened or, you know, whether this was a good thing for them or not, what I knew was somebody else had lost somebody today. And for me, that hurt me. You know, I feel for other people. I feel for the people who did lose that patient today. And I just cry for them. I cry, you know, that was a soul that we don't have here. And we won't get the joy from that person. And I won't know their story. So that really made me really sad that day. And that was, you know, no, I don't know if I'll ever come to terms with it. And I know a lot of people say like, oh, you know, you'll get used to it, or you're just gonna have to learn to leave that part of you at home. I'm like, leave that part of me at home? Like, how is it that you leave? How do you just like take your heart out and just leave it on the shelf? Like, where do I leave it? Like, do I leave it in my dresser? You know, do I like put it in a basket on my way out the door in the morning? Like, where do I leave that part of me, that great part of me that makes me the compassionate person that I am, that makes me want to go into this field and want to help people, that part of me that I go to the grocery store and will literally see someone needing help and I'm like, hey, I can help you, you know, don't even know this person, just being nosy, you know? Like, how do I leave that at home? Like, that is the better part of me. And people say, you know, like, you'll learn to just leave that and separate it. But I don't know if I really want to separate it. You know, is that something I really want to do? Like, not bring my compassion? Do I want to be that person who's at the hospital rolling her eyes at the next patient that come in because she's irritated at, you know, it's time for her shift to be over, or this patient is irritating her, you know, and whatever, you know? Like, do I want to be that person, or I want to be that person that like really has some passion for people and that really genuinely wants to help them or care for them or love them? You know, do I want to leave that part of me at home? You know, so I don't know if I'll ever be able to like leave that part of me at home. You know, I don't know. I don't know if I'll ever be able to do that. I do think that as time progresses, that I will get stronger in dealing with it for the families of individuals, that if that's a field that I choose to go into, I might not ever have to deal with something like that again. But I do want to get stronger in that aspect, that when I come to a family, that I'm not the one hysterically crying, that I can be in a situation where I can console them and still be a little strong for them. So, because I literally see people crying and hurting. Like, when I see someone hurting, not just crying, but hurting, that hurts me. That truly hurts me, you know? So I kind of like, I'm like, I'm not gonna cry, you know? I'm not gonna cry. But, you know, it hurts me because I love people and I love helping people. I love people, you know? So, I don't know. I don't know. I do what I do because I genuinely want to help people. I'm sorry, but I genuinely do what I do because, you know, people matter, no matter who they are or, you know, what they do or, you know, what they've done in this world, they matter. And they matter to me, you know? Like, I don't have to know your story for you to matter. You know, like, I love you just the same. So, you know, I don't know. But that was my, you know, first death in nursing. I expect to get more. I do expect to become stronger. Sorry. In dealing with things such as a death, with nursing, just in life general, and I expect to get stronger in that, and I expect to make it to be a better nurse, to be able to have my compassion and help individuals and show that love and it to be shown in a way without having to cry all the time for my patients. Because it truly would hurt me to have to show up to my facility and these patients that I truly, you know, just love seeing their smiles every day, to know that one of them was not there. You know, like, that would hurt me. I'm not gonna talk about that anymore, but I, again, said I'm done with my first class in school. You know, if you wanna know, like, what are some stresses, like, why did I fail my practicum, or does anything about nursing school, just go ahead and put it in the comment section below. I have some extra time before my next semester starts, so I am looking forward to doing some extra videos and things like that, just between now and May, before I get started for you guys. So if there's anything that you want or want to know, just definitely put it in the comment section below and let me know. And if you guys see somebody else put something in the comment section below, just hit the little heart thing on there. And the more hearts and the more comments that I get, the more that I will, you know, the more encouraged I'll be to make that video. So, all right, you guys, thank you for following my process, and I will see you soon.